Hello, my name is Alex Mejia, and I'm an Associate Professor of Engineering Education at the University of Texas at San Antonio. In this series of videos, I will be talking about the importance of strengths-based practices in engineering education, particularly fronts of knowledge. Throughout these videos, I will be using the term Latinx as a gender-inclusive identifier that recognizes LGBTQ+ individuals with Latin American roots. Fronts of knowledge is the existing cultural knowledge and skills present in an individual's household, community, and culture. Every person has their own fronts of knowledge, but this knowledge is not always recognized and appreciated, especially the knowledge from communities of color. I became interested in the topic of fronts of knowledge during my graduate school, where my dissertation advisor invited me to be part of one of her research projects. It was through this experience that I started to make connections between my own personal story and how sometimes my own academic achievement and that of my classmates was perceived to be the result of inadequate home learning experiences, lack of parental support, and even my own culture, which could not be further from the truth. But these views created an acceptance of lowered expectations while serving to further marginalize Latinx youth, like me, from participating in STEM. In contrast, a fronts of knowledge approach celebrates the experiences from home and culture that people have and creates openings and opportunities for Latinx youth to engage in STEM activities. In the early 90s, Carlos Vélez Ibáñez and James Greenberg sought to investigate how Latinx families in the Southwest US-Mexico borderlands gain and share knowledge to respond to their economic, environmental, and social landscape. This collection of historical and socially accumulated cultural knowledge, skills, and practices, as well as the recognition of communities as education resources, is what became known as fronts of knowledge. An example of fronts of knowledge that the researchers described is how the Latinx families adapted to the lack of access to doctors. Many of the families described in the research were living in the sparsely populated Southwest, meaning there were very few doctors that were accessible or affordable for families. The situation led families to rely on and develop remedies and first aid procedures based on their ancestral folk medical knowledge. The primary goal of defining fronts of knowledge in the research was to emphasize that this wealth of knowledge had a strategic importance for economic well-being and survival for Latinx families. Research into fronts of knowledge continued in the 1980s and the 1990s, but this time specifically related to the education of Latinx students. The prevailing narrative at that time about Mexican-American households was that they were inadequate at preparing children for school and that students came into the classroom as empty vessels. Researchers collaborated with and co-designed new narratives with Mexican-American families that detailed the rich source of educational resources found in these communities. A group of researchers at the University of Arizona invited teachers to visit the homes of their own students to focus on practice. That is, what is it that people do and what they say about what they do? The Fronts of Knowledge project was meant to help teachers learn about their students and acknowledge their homes and communities as spaces in which students gain valuable strengths, resources, and knowledge. The project developed confianza, or trust, among teachers and students and their families. Through lived experiences, households and communities accumulate a variety of complex knowledge. This knowledge can range from knowing about local edible plants for survival to practicing blacksmithing and mechanics for the maintenance of their essential equipment. We know that the more youth can personally identify with an educational topic, the more interest and motivation for learning will exist. A fronts of knowledge grounding allows for educators to reflect on existing knowledge and skills that their youth have in order to provide engaging, strengths-based educational experiences.